Before he speaks, let me just let me wrap this. Because he is going to be a greater thanks because we have come to the end of this part of the program. And we were going to screen this movie, Kuzulani, but we decided that let's share Kuzulani and have Sibusiso suffer that period of time. And the kids please feel it so wanted to play, they say. All work and no play makes kids pass. But I'm not well, you know. So we're gonna go and play after this. I want to say something about that movie. Out here, one of the things that we heard is that we need to be multi-talented, we need to be multifaceted, because we don't know what to do now, so that you can take or you can seize opportunities. Or if you are in a corner, you can be able to get yourself out of the corner. And if you see that there's a banner there that says money and investments, and there's a lady there in a white dress, and that's me. And during the lockdown, I managed to get somebody. I was facilitating people to write their own names. And so I created a project called The Writer's Lab. And The Writer's Lab is a platform, a digital platform, for me to facilitate your story about yourself. Not about anything else, but about yourself. So, through the writing there, the one that I did during the lockdown, I managed to ask the, I applied for funding and get some funding. Now I'll be facilitating four people to write their names. Yes. Kffa. Thank you for all this quality. Because I have 1966 Latin English. And they have 2000 English. So, basically, what I'm saying is that I was living nicely. In 2018, I decided, okay, let me once again take my dream, go and live in the States. Take my bags, take my kids, rent and live in Los Angeles. Settled nicely, and COVID came. And when COVID came, it came when I was a consultant and came to South Africa to do training with the government. And I was in the middle of training, I heard the president is coming, announcing, there's going to be an announcement, and the gates are closing, the borders are closing. So anyone who is not from here, is not. Or anyone who is outside is either you come back here or you stay where you are because there's this COVID-19. So I'm in the border doing some training and then I decided what do I do? Do I belong to South Africa or do I belong in the States? And I decided, okay, my daughter is in the States. Let me go there. That's where I'll be going. And then back to the States. This is now in March. In 20. Then there, when I got there, they said, we closed our borders. Told me, we can't accept you. Go back to your country. And I had to come back. And I told them that, look, I'm going to go home. So you can't close me down. I said, it's either you need your daughter here or you take your daughter with you. And then I put my daughter with him back to South Africa. That's when I managed to come to it. Because that memory was shot in February, February of 2020. Because I was supporting the South African student that made that platform. She's from Kffa. And the whole cast, not the whole cast, but the majority of the cast of South African students that are based in Kenya. They are studying film at the New York Film Academy, the LA branch. And as an activist and mankaps, and when I was mankap, he's always wanting to support kids. So I put together a group of South African kids to give them support, to call them during Thanksgiving, cook in the show for them, put up a women's school that much. So I was doing that with them, and then they said, Mankaps, we need somebody who can speak Sicily, because she was doing her thesis with the women. I went, and my daughter was saying, what? And I said, yeah, I can go and act. If anyone can act, I can act too. So, and then we came back, and now we're here. And when we got here, and we left in the Pentagon, we had taken with us. And then I had to start a pitch. I had to leave my grandmother and my mother and came to this. And we did have a plan up to this point. Now, here's what I want to say to you. Before you're born, you are alive. Just even if you don't understand this, but put it in your mind, before you were born, you are alive. Because you are a spirit, you are a soul, and soul is another thing. So, as a soul, you decide that I'm going to take a journey into life, and go in your body, and experience life. And you came into life, you got a body, and you are alive now. Then at the end of your life, you think you do a life, you do it, you do it, you do it, and then at the end of your life, you have the body. You move back into your soul again, which is the same soul that never dies. It never dies. And I'm saying this to say to you, your life is not yours. Whatever happens in your life, like from that time when you get born, let's say it's here, from the time you get born to the time which is the end of your life here, you are responsible for that part. And you can do anything. And you can be anywhere. And you can be anything. You can decide to be kind, you can decide to be cool, you can decide to be powerful. At some stage I was a top person in Ghana. At another stage I was a company consultant. At another stage I was an actress in a movie that was good. At another stage I was a coach. At another stage I was a trainer in my body. At another stage I'm here. I'm a filmmaker. So everything between the time you're born and the time you die, you are responsible for your life. And you can be in it. You don't have to hold yourself down. You can explore anything about yourself. I know I don't have the time to say, but maybe I can. I'm not saying. So, with those words, I want to say, its purse. Women Oversight Committee, something like that oversees the film festival and our process. And then there's a party, those ladies that are sitting at the back, and then the kids press going on the seconds. So, Kffa, the gentleman behind that camera, the tallest guy in the room, they belong to the Oversight Committee of Kids Pass, of the Kids. And they want to say something, they are my bosses. They want to say something before we leave. Thank you very much, guys. Good afternoon. How are you? I'm just a parent who's not in the program, but I'm very touched. As I was sitting back there, I was just reminiscing about the good old days when this lady who has just spoken was an inspiration to a family. When I say a family, I say everybody was around her, and I happened to be maybe where I am because I saw what she could do in life. She comes from a family where even her mother is a go-getter. We want to say, as parents, even though I haven't spoken to any other parent, but I think they feel, or they have the same sentiments as myself, to say thank you very much for having that seed that came as a vision. Because we're planting a seed to these kids. And what is going to germinate out of the seeds that you are planting is something wonderful. And this is something that is going to take them to any space in the world. They just need to not be afraid. If there is someone in front of you who is able to do anything, you can also do anything. And unlike us, opportunities are there for you. We didn't have any opportunities. We used to play with balls made of plastic. We used to play with tins. And we are playing with technology. And with technology, you can do anything. This woman in the family was the first raglan. And when she was wearing that black robe, we wanted to say, I want to be the first girl, like this woman. And seeing her having achieved things that are being achieved in our country, achieved by maids, it is something that is making me very, very excited. And to the team that is supporting her, this is a journey that we will support, and this is a journey that we need to touch each and every corner of South Africa, even the world, to say, can this thing go on and not stop here? Funds, I think, are needed for this project. And wherever we can get funds, please let's do. Thank you very much to the entire team.
Thanks, my turn now. I'm joking. I'm just here to give a vote of thanks. I'd like to give thanks to the organizers of the Kids Pass Film Festival of this great success of the day. Sikalengo, Mom, Miss Nomakabiso Mashao, Mom Nomakabiso Mashao to all of us. The founder and director, Zila Gandu, and the creator of the Kids Pass Film Festival, and also my mother. And we'd like to thank the core team that has helped organize this. I will name you Tembeka Khemane at the back, the project administrator. Thank you very much. Mrs. Spogazi's Lota Laka, executive assistant. We thank you over there at the back. Mrs. Sarah Chamberlain, the participants tutor, we thank you very much there at the back, taking care of the kids. Ms. Pumela Msolo, public relations officer, we thank you there at the back. And a lady that is not with us at the moment, who's in Lenon Duangu, events coordinator, we thank her very much as well. There you go, give them a round of applause. And then, as she mentioned, the Oversight Committee, we would like to thank Mr. Aubrey Slinyana, the man on the camera, the very friendly giant. OC Production, thank you very much. And then we thank the lady who's Andile Nkonyeni, OC Media. She is currently not here, but we'd like to give her a round of applause. Thank you. Ubulelwa Kulashe, right? All right, and she's OC Kids. We'd like to thank her as well. And And then Umletim Kuku, OC Film. You were informed he will not be here at all this weekend, but we'd still like to thank him very much as well. And then this great person, Kumalo Zipo. OC Youth, we'd like to thank him very much. Alright, and then the most important people, the parents of Kids Pass, who have given the time to allow you guys to be part of this great opportunity. Please give them a hug and a kiss and say thank you. And then furthermore, we'd like to give a special thanks to the media companies that got the word out about this event. We'd like to thank KFC Media, Algoa FM, Ugani FM, 2FM, and SAFM, and among many others. We'd like to thank Zara Lodge as well for hosting you guys. Come on, give them a round of applause. Don't stop, let's go. Yes, sir. All right, and we would like to thank you, my great sir, Sonwa Sawuba. We'd like to thank you for the honor to use this venue and to integrate with your academy. We are now able to share the same dream, and we hope, and it's the birth of a beautiful future together, sir. No doubt. Thank you. Okay, and then to our guests of the day, we are very honored, very, very honored to have you here, Mr. Sibusiso. We are very blessed to have you here to impart knowledge. We hope this relationship continues to grow and the kids use this opportunity to learn more through this relationship. Thank you very much, sir. Advent, gotta subscribe. And then it's unfathomable. How grateful we are to have you here, Mr. Mbuso. Thank you. You cannot fathom. Thank you. Thank you for entertaining us today and pushing us through this day, laughter and everything. We hope this relationship continues with you as well. Thank you very much, sir. And then, last but not least, I don't know if I should thank these guys, but I will. I want to thank you, the ambassadors. I want to thank you for reaching for your dreams and choosing to be a part of this opportunity. As they said today, keep your light bright and keep striving for your dreams. Okay. You guys answer me. Okay. Are you ready? If you want, great. Thank you very much, guys. Enjoy.
Yes, kids. We don't have much for you guys. Not now. Maybe later. We can play with you. And right now, we are going to be distributing cards to our dancers to Major. Electric Avenue to play. Tomorrow we're going to the beach in the morning. We have a discussion to do, and then we have the red carpet, we have a warm night, and we'll be streaming on KFS Media, KFS Radio platforms, Facebook, YouTube, and also visiting an hour at Kids Pass. Please do work with the most influential artist, the most promising artist, the most enthusiastic